because they wanted to hear the rest of the story. So it goes on to say, suppose you were living in Bethlehem that night. Imagine you and your brother, like Bryce and James, were sleeping on top of the roof, and they were wondering what was going on. They heard their folks talk about the fact that the Messiah was supposed to be born. The prophets had said it would happen, and it would happen in their town of Bethlehem. Imagine how you'd feel if that was going to happen in Richmond. I never saw so many people in town, he said. I wonder how long they will stay. Oh, I suppose till the taxing is over. I've been wondering. Father's been telling us lately that the Messiah is coming, and he's supposed to be born here. Yes, he's supposed to be born here, said the prophet Micah. Look, there's a star in the sky. What is that? Where is it? That light, can you believe how bright it is? Look, it's over the inn. No, it isn't. It's over the stable behind the inn. What can be happening? Let's go and see. Don't wake up anybody. Let's be quiet. Silently, you creep down the stairs and cross the road and walk up toward the inn. Suddenly you stop, for the light seems to move out of town. You run past the guards at the gate and across the field to the place where the shepherds are keeping their sheep tonight. You see a group of men standing open-mouthed as a glorious being is talking to them. Can this be the Messiah, you wonder? Oh, surely not. Then it must be an angel, you hear him saying, "Fear not. For behold, you, I tell you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." Did you hear that? He said the Messiah is here, that he's been born already. Shh, listen, the angel's still speaking. "And this shall be a sign to you. You'll find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." Suddenly, you see a perfectly marvelous sight. Right before your eyes, a whole multitude of angels and shining lights, all singing glory to God in the highest. The whole heaven is flooded with light. Everywhere it's as bright as day. You can see the rugged mountains all around you, and the shepherds and the trembling sheep, and every building in Bethlehem. "Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest," said the angels. Then more gently, "Peace on earth, goodwill toward men." How tenderly and hopefully they sing these closing words, as it is as if they long to see men everywhere welcome their Savior with open arms and make him the Lord of their life. Suddenly as they came, the angels disappeared. It's darkness again. You watch the shepherds to see what they will do. "Let's go to Bethlehem," they say. "Let's see this thing which has come to pass." "Let's go at once," they all cry, and you see them hurrying off toward the city, stumbling over rocks and briars in their haste, but getting up and hurrying. You hunt behind them to see where they will go. Then pass a sleepy-eyed citizen near the inn. "Was a baby born around here tonight?" a shepherd asked. "Oh, yes, down there in the stable." They run in, run on. It's still dark, though dawn is on the way. They see a light in a crack. "What is that? A baby's crying. This must be the place." They push open the door and they peer inside, and you're right behind them. At the far end, a man is standing, and beside him, a young woman is resting in the hay. Beside her in a manger is a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. "Surely, this must be that baby the angel spoke about. He must be the promised Savior, Christ the Lord." Reverently, the shepherds enter the stable. Joseph and Mary look up startled, wondering about these strange, rough men who are coming here at this time of night. One of the shepherds begins. begin to explain about what had happened out in the field. And who told them, that the angels told them that the Messiah would be born and they would find him laying in a manger. If you remember in our story the other day, Mary was wondering why the Son of God was being born in the manger. This time her eyes are glowing. She understands and she is glad. Now she's sure that God has not forgotten her. He knows where the baby is, even though he's lying in a manger. Over and over again, the shepherds tell their story, first one and then another, adding fresh details. And it dawns upon them very clearly that this is indeed the long-promised Messiah, the Son of the living God. They bid goodbye to Mary and Joseph and go on their way back to the sheep. People are waking up and getting breakfast. Some are tending animals, and they look at the shepherds in astonishment as they stop and tell them the story about the angels in the street that night. "You saw angels," someone said to them. "Angels in Bethlehem?" "Yes, indeed. A multitude of heavenly angels praising God." "Impossible." "But we did. They told us the Messiah was born." "Messiah born here last night? Oh, no, that couldn't be." "Yes, indeed, it's true. He's in the stable over there behind the inn." And all they that heard it wondered at these things. Some believed their stories, others did not. Some went to the stable to see the child, others didn't bother. They were busy with their daily chores, washing dishes, cleaning house, feeding animals, and making money. How is it any different today? This is not the end of the story, folks. It was only the beginning of the story. But Jesus is coming back. Could be in our generation, only God really knows. So I hope that you're ready. We might be able to look out there in the sky and see it open up, and Christ coming, blowing a trumpet, and the angels shouting. It's not going to be a quiet affair at all. So I'd like all of you to be ready. I'd like us all to be there as a family. Thank you.